In this video, we're continuing on with the proportional parts in triangles and parallel lines worksheet on the CUDA software website. You can find this within the geometry section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Our directions for numbers 7 through 10 are to find the missing length indicated. This side length of 25 over our missing side length, let's call that missing side length x, is going to be proportional to the side length 15 over 6. Cross multiplying, I'll have 25 times 6 equal to 15x. 25 times 6 is 150, and that's equal to 15x. So when I divide by 15, I'll get that x is equal to 150 divided by 15, which is 10. So x is equal to 10 and number 7. So 10 is my missing length. And number 8, this entire length is 77. So if my missing length is y, then this length will be 77 minus y. Now I'll set up my proportion. Y over 77 minus y is going to be proportional to 30 over 25. Cross multiplying, y times 25 equals 30 times 77 minus y. So I'll go ahead and distribute that 30. So 25y equals 30 times 77, which is 2,310, and we're subtracting 30 times y, which is 30y. So I'll add 30y to both sides in order to get my terms with y on the left-hand side of my equation. 25y plus 30y is 55y, and that is equal to 2,310. Dividing by 55, I'll get that y is equal to 42. So our missing length in number 8 is 42. In number 9, looking towards the right, this total length is 11. So this shorter length is going to be 11 minus this length of 5. And 11 minus 5 is 6. So we'll have 5 over 6. That's going to be proportional to this length over our indicated length. And our indicated length, let's call this x, so that other length will be 22 minus x, since 22 is the total distance. So 22 minus x over x. Now we'll cross multiply. So 5 times x is going to be equal to 6 times 22 minus x. Distributing the 6, we'll get 5x equal to 6 times 22, which is 132, minus 6 times x, which is 6x. Now I'll add 6x to both sides in order to get my terms with my variable on the left. So 5x plus 6x is 11x, and that's equal to 132. And when I divide by 11, I'll get that x, our missing length, is equal to 12. So 12 is the solution in number 9. In number 10, the only length we're missing is our indicated length, and that we'll call r. So r over 28 equals 8 over 16. R over 28 is proportional to 8 over 16. Cross multiplying, R times 16 equals 8 times 28. So 16R is going to be equal to 8 times 28, which is 224. And when I divide both sides by 16, in order to isolate that R, get that variable all by itself, 224 divided by 16 will give me 14. So 14 is the solution in number 10. R is 14. Now for numbers 11 through 12, we're going to be solving for x. So this total length on my right-hand side is 35. So this length is going to be 35 minus 25, and 35 minus 25 is equal to 10. So I'll have 25 over 10 is going to be proportional to this length over 22. However, that length is going to be 7 plus 14x minus 22. So now let's cross multiply and solve for x. We'll have 25 times 22 equal to 10 times 7 plus 14x minus 22. I'm going to simplify what's in the parentheses, combining 7 and 22, and I'm also going to multiply 25 by 22. 25 times 22 is 550, and that's equal to 10 times 14x minus 15, or plus a negative 15. Now I know that 10 goes into 550 evenly, so my next step will be to divide by 10 as opposed to distributing it. 550 divided by 10 is 55. So 55 equals 14x minus 15. I'll add 15 to both sides in order to isolate my variable with the x, in order to isolate my term that contains the variable. 55 plus 15 is 70. So 70 equals 14x. And when I divide by 14, I'll get that 5 is equal to x. So x represents the number 5 in problem 11. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 12. However, before I work through the answer to this, please remember to click that subscribe button and also click the thumbs up button if you found this video helpful. Now, starting on number 12, we're going to calculate this length, which is 10 minus 4. So that'll give us 6. So 4 over 6 is going to be proportional to 2x minus 10 over 9. Cross multiplying, 4 times 9 will equal 6 times 2x minus 10. 4 times 9 is 36, and 36 equals 6 times 2x minus 10. I know that 6 can go into 36 evenly, so I'll divide by 6 as opposed to distributing. 36 divided by 6 is 6, and that's equal to 2x minus 10. Adding 10 to both sides will isolate my term with the variable, which is 2x. So 6 plus 10 is 16, and 16 will equal 2x. Now all I have left to do is divide by 2. 16 divided by 2 is 8, so 8 is equal to x. So 8 is my solution for the last problem in this video. If you have any comments, leave them below. Continue on to the next video where I'll complete this worksheet, finishing problems 13 through 18. Also, if you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share.